क्लास 11 कॉमर्स टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस योर चैप्टर सेकेंड बेसिक टर्म्स ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. तो व्हाट इज बेसिक टर्म्स ऑफ अकाउंटिंग इन बिजनेस. वेरियस अकाउंटिंग टर्म्स आर यूज्ड. इट इज नेसेसरी टू अंडरस्टैंड दीज टर्म्स एज दे आर पार्ट ऑफ द स्टैंडर्ड अकाउंटिंग टर्मिनोलॉजी. सो व्हाट इज अकाउंटिंग टर्म? अकाउंटिंग टर्म, देयर आर सर्टेन बेसिक अकाउंटिंग टर्म विच आर डेली यूज इन द बिजनेस वर्ल्ड बिफोर recording the transaction in the books it is essential to understand these terms have their specific meaning in accounting. These basic terms are called accounting terminology, and it means accounting terms or accounting terminology, both are same. So I am going to discuss one by one accounting terminology. First is capital. Capital means when a businessman invest money in business from their personal property is known as capital. Second is drawing. When businessman withdrew money from business for their personal use is known as drawing. See here, a businessman purchased a bike for personal use of rupees 1 lakh amount withdrew from business. So rupees 1 lakh is called drawing. Next accounting term is assets. Assets means property of the business. Simply, property of the business. Suppose that building, furniture, land, cash, bank deposit, stock, data, machinery. There are two types of assets. First is current assets. Second is non-current assets. Current assets means those assets which are purchased or manufactured for resale, or those assets which are easily converted into cash or cash equivalent. Those assets for which are purchased for resale or which is easily converted into cash or cash equivalent, such as stock, debtor, bills receivable, cash, bank, prepaid expenses. Next is non-current assets. Non-current assets are those assets which are not easily converted into cash. And this is for the business on use, not for sale, and whose life is more than 1 year. Suppose building, land, furniture. Non-current assets also divided in two parts. First is tangible assets, second is intangible assets. Tangible assets means those assets which can be seen and touched. Suppose furniture, building, machinery. But intangible assets mean those assets which cannot be seen or touched. Suppose that goodwill, patent. Goodwill means good name or good fame of business is known as goodwill. It is a very important asset for the business. Next accounting term is liabilities. Liabilities means burden of the business. Means it refers to amount which the firm owed to outsider. Any amount have to paid after some time to someone at present, this amount is known as liability. Means I have taken a loan from bank. This loan will have to be paid after some time because it is an liability for me. Liability is also divided in two parts. First is current liability, second is non-current liability. Liabilities which are paid within 1 year is known as current liability. Suppose that creditor. But liability which are paid after 1 year known as non-current liability. Suppose a debenture. Non-current liability means which are paid after 1 year. Current liability means which are paid within 1 year. Today I am going to discuss your next terminology, debtor. Debtor means debtor represent those person or firm to whom goods or services have been sold on credit or payment has not been received from them. For example, goods sold to Ram rupees 10,000 but amount has not been received. He will be continue to remain the debtor of the business so long as he does not make the full payment. नेक्स्ट क्रेडिटर, इफ द बिजनेसमैन बाय गुड्स और सर्विसेज ऑन क्रेडिट एंड अमाउंट इज स्टिल टू बी पेड टू द पर्सन और अदर एंटिटीज, दीज आर कॉल्ड क्रेडिटर, दीज आर लायबिलिटी फॉर द बिजनेस. नेक्स्ट इज बिल्स रिसीवेबल. बिल्स रिसीवेबल इज एन अकाउंटिंग टर्म ऑफ बिल्स ऑफ एक्सचेंज. अ बिल्स ऑफ एक्सचेंज इज बिल्स रिसीवेबल फॉर सेलर एट द टाइम ऑफ क्रेडिट सेल. नेक्स्ट इज बिल्स पेबल. बिल्स पेबल इज ऑल्सो एन अकाउंटिंग टर्म ऑफ बिल्स ऑफ एक्सचेंज. अ बिल्स ऑफ एक्सचेंज इज बिल्स पेबल फॉर परचेजर एट टाइम ऑफ क्रेडिट परचेज. नेक्स्ट इज डिस्काउंट. डिस्काउंट इज द रिबेट गिवेन बाय द सेलर. डिस्काउंट आर डिवाइडेड इन टू पार्ट्स. फर्स्ट इज ट्रेड डिस्काउंट, सेकेंड इज कैश डिस्काउंट. द पर्पस ऑफ दिस डिस्काउंट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड द बायर टू बाय मोर गुड्स. इट इज ऑफर्ड एट एन एग्रीड परसेंटेज ऑफ लिस्ट प्राइस. एट द टाइम ऑफ सेलिंग गुड्स दिस डिस्काउंट इज नॉट रिकॉर्डेड इन द अकाउंटिंग बुक. कैश डिस्काउंट, द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग कैश डिस्काउंट इज टू इनकरेज द डेटर टू पे द ड्यूज प्रमोटली. दिस डिस्काउंट इज रिकॉर्डिंग इन द बुक्स. नेक्स्ट इज परचेज. द टर्म्स ऑफ परचेज इज यूज ओनली फॉर द गुड्स प्रोसीड बाई अ बिजनेस फॉर रिसेल. Purchase return or return outward. When purchased goods are returned to the supplier, these are known as purchase return or return outward. Sales. Sales are total revenue from goods sold or services provided to customer. Sale may be cash sale or credit sale. Next is sales return. When goods sold are return from customers due to any reason is known as sales return or return inward. Expenses. Cost incurred by a business for earning revenue are known as expenses. For example, rent, wages, salary, interest, etc. Okay. Thank you. These are totally accounting term.